There's lots of amazing weather phenomena happening all over our planet, but what's going on outside of our atmosphere? My name is Leland Melvin, and as an astronaut, I can tell you weather conditions in space can be a matter of life and death, especially during a spacewalk. When we prepare for a spacewalk, we have to be able to deal with temperatures that range from positive 250 degrees Fahrenheit in the sun and minus 250 degrees in the shade. But in our spacesuit, we have the ability to withstand those temperature extremes because we have visors that reflect the sun away from our eyes, and we have heated gloves as well as a heated suit. And then we have cooling that allows us to stay cool during those temperature extremes. A solar flare is a sudden flash of brightness observed near the sun's surface that emits X-ray and UV radiation. In space, the radiation levels can be deadly. When we're notified of a solar flare on the space station, we retreat to what we call the doghouse. This doghouse is lined with water bags that allow us to block the radiation coming from the sun before it gets to our bodies. And that's where we go to keep from getting exposed to high energy radiation. As we go further out into our solar system, weather events become more and more extreme. Jupiter, our solar system's biggest planet, also features its most impressive storm, the Great Red Spot. The gigantic tempest is twice as wide as planet Earth and has winds that reach up to 400 miles per hour. It's been swirling over Jupiter for at least 150 years. Further out, Neptune features its own great big storm. It takes up the planet's entire atmosphere. Neptune is our solar system's windiest planet, with wind speeds that can reach up to 1,500 miles per hour. That's 9 times faster than the strongest winds ever recorded on Earth. To find the strongest known winds in our universe, we have to go well beyond our solar system. Astrophysicists at York University have discovered the fastest winds ever recorded near a supermassive black hole. These wind speeds clock in at 125 million miles per hour. I hope my crew never gets caught up in anything like that.